Eli, thank the Lord this morning. Many are called, but few are chosen. I believe this morning, I told him up home not long ago, Brother Estwell, I said, I heard the phrase my whole life, separate the men from the boys. And COVID has separated those that are truly saved Amen. To those that walk by sight
right.
and not by faith.
That's right.
Amen. Don't know about you, but I'm determined to go all the way.
Bless the Lord.
Amen. Amen. I'd rather be an old-time Christian
Amen.
Than Bless anything I know Amen. This morning.
Amen.
Amen. I appreciate your hearts this morning,
Bless
the
Lord.
Testimonies and the songs. Good to be in a group of people, amen, that truly love the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Churches all across Amen. The land, not only in this country, but countries afar, their numbers have dropped. Amen. Amen. People, did you realize that fear is a spirit? And the Bible said we're not to fear that. Amen. I'm thankful this morning that when I got saved, amen, I got the real thing.
Amen.
Amen. It changed my life.
Sir.
Amen. I thank God for that. And I listened to all that was being said this morning in prayer requests and in testimonies. And I want you to know you're not alone this morning. Amen. It's all across this land.
Amen.
Amen. Our children are lost. Amen. Our grandchildren are lost.
Right.
Amen. We're
right.
living in a land that has no desire for God.
Right.
Amen. They're going their That's own right. direction, their own ways.
That's right.
Amen. But I'm glad this morning. You pray that God will bless. I thought how that, amen, that this country, our government, amen, from every level, you can't determine truth from a lie. Amen. We're living in a time to where biblical principles, morals, and values have been set to the left side. Amen. No one wants to be obedient unto the Spirit of the Lord anymore. We're just living in biblical times. Amen. You read the Word of God and you realize we're there. And I thought one thing about it, though. Amen. I've got the absolute truth in my hand this morning. Amen. There's a lot of things. There's a lot of religions. Amen. Oprah says there's like 99 ways to be able to go to heaven. Amen. But I read where Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life.
Amen.
No man can come unto the Father. Amen. Unless the Spirit draw him.
Amen.
You pray. Amen. I've been privileged for many, many years now, 36 years or so, to be able to travel and preach revivals across the land. And such, but I am a pastor, amen. God called me to pastor, Brother Estwell, so I'm going to preach a pastoral message, if that's all right. Amen. And if you don't like what the Lord has to say this morning, amen, you talk to your pastor about that, amen. But we want you to turn your Bibles, if you have them this morning, to the third chapter of the book of Exodus. Third chapter of the book of Exodus, and you pray for just a little while. Amen. I'm not going to go through this entire message this morning as I studied it out. Amen. And in fact, you'd find that this scripture and what we're going to use as a text this morning is found throughout the book of Exodus and even into the book of Numbers. Amen. But you pray this morning that God will bless this morning. And I want to be an encouragement to your hearts this morning if the Lord will let us. I'm not that old, but I'm not that young. But I've never in my lifetime seen a time to where God's people seem to be scattered abroad. see, and here's the thing now. I don't know about down here, but I'm sure it's the same. But I have them tell me and call me and text me, and they'll get a hold of me on Facebook and all kind of things. And they'll say, "Preacher, we're not going to be at church today. We're afraid of COVID. Yeah. We're afraid of this. And the county's on red alert. And this." They'll make every kind of excuse that there is. It may not to be in the house of God, but as soon as I go to Walmart, amen, to buy a gallon of milk, I'll see them in Walmart, amen. Let me tell you, there's more people in Walmart than there are sitting in Grace Free Will Baptist this morning, amen. But I know this, I'm determined to go all the way, amen, with the Lord. How about you this morning, amen? I know they're falling to the left. In fact, the Bible said that there would be a falling away, amen. I told them like this, Brother Estill, you can't fall away if you ain't never had it, amen. If you ain't never been there, you can't fall away from it, amen.
Amen.
You pray. Yeah. All right, now in the 17th verse of the 3rd chapter of the book of Exodus, we're going to read 2 verses. And again, we ask you to pray that the Spirit will move. I can't preach unless the Spirit moved this morning. Amen. The Bible said, and I have said, I will bring you up out of the affliction of Egypt unto the land of the Canaanites and the Hittites and the Amorites and the Perizzites and the Hivites and the Jebusites, and unto the land flowing with milk and honey.
Amen. Amen.
Have a determination to make it to that land one of these days. And the Bible said, and they shall hearken to the voice, and thou shalt come, and the elders of Israel unto the king of Egypt. And he shall say unto them, the Lord God of the Hebrews has met with us, and now let us go, we beseech thee, 3 days' journey into the wilderness, that we may sacrifice to the Lord our God. Amen. Now, just to set the stage, if you would, for just a moment, this is a period of time, amen, to where Moses has been called of God. He has done stood before the bush that burned with fire. And God had said unto Moses, after Moses had already fled from Egypt, God is now ready to send Moses back unto the land of the Egyptians. Amen. And so God has called him and said, my people have been in affliction and in bondage for too long now. And I want you to go, and I want you to bring them out of bondage and lead them to a land that flows with milk and honey.
Amen.
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 And that's what God said. Amen. And then Moses, you know, said unto God, whom shall I say has sent me? Amen. And God said, let them know that I am. Amen. Aren't you glad that he still is? Amen. Before Abraham, he said, I am, I was, I'll always be. Amen. And so therefore, Moses goes down to the Egypt land. And the Bible said, amen, when he got there, he was to say unto Pharaoh, amen, to let my people go.
Amen.
And he was to say to Pharaoh, we're to go amen, for the children of Israel. And to go 3 days under the wilderness and sacrifice. Amen, now 3 day journey. Amen. Is about 60 miles. Amen. And God said, I want you to go a 3 day journey into the land. And there you're to sacrifice unto the Lord. And then over in the 8th chapter of the book of Exodus, and the Bible said in verse 27, he said, we will go a 3 days journey into the wilderness and sacrifice to the Lord our God as he shall command us. And Pharaoh said, I will let you go that you may sacrifice to the Lord and your God in the wilderness. Now listen to this. Amen. Listen to what the Bible said. Amen. And Pharaoh said, I'll let you go that you may sacrifice unto your God in the wilderness. Only ye shall not go very far away. Amen. Do you realize, a church this morning? Amen. That's what the devil wants. Amen. Is for you and I. Amen. Not to go very far. I'm with the Lord. Amen. Hey, I don't know about down here in Lexington, but I know in our land, amen, we've got those, amen, that live every day, and they have no desire, and to go 3 day journey, amen, and they don't want to go very far, with the Lord, amen. What do you mean, preacher? Amen. Hey, do you realize, amen, that the old devil doesn't care, and that you come to church every now and again? Amen. He doesn't care if you sing a song every once in a while. Amen. Just as long as you don't go very far. Amen. But I'm determined, amen, in my heart, I'm to go 3 day a journey. I'm gonna go all the way with God. Amen. I've got my mind made up and my foot on the rock. Hey, and the Bible said, I seek out the old path and walk therein. He said, I'm the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. I'm gonna go all the way unto the end. And the Bible said, he that endureth unto the end, and Brother Jeff, the same shall be saved. I'm gonna go all the way. Amen. Pharaoh said, eyes unto your God. But just don't go very far away. Amen. Hey, you pray. I ain't got much of a voice. Amen. But I thought the Bible said Moses said unto them, amen, I said, we can't do that. I said, the animals that we use as a sacrifice are the very animals that ye Egyptians worship. And if we sacrifice in front of you, surely they'd stone us. Amen. And I thought like this. Amen. Are we not living in a time, amen, to where our way of worship is ungodly? Amen. Unto the world. Amen. Unto where right has become wrong, and wrong has become right. But I don't know about you, but as far as my house, we're going to serve the living God, the one, the precious one who died.
Amen.
Abraham, I don't know why I have another voice for the rest of it. Abraham, but I know I'm determined to go 3 days' journey into the wilderness. Pharaoh said no. You can't go very far and worship. But you can worship, just don't go very far. Amen. But Moses said, Pharaoh, no, God said we've got to go 3 days, and that's what we're going to do. Can I tell you, church, God said you and I have got to stay on the straight and narrow path. You and I have to go the way of the gospel of Jesus Christ. No other way. Man try to go in any other way, he's the same as a thief and a robber. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Moses later comes back with Aaron, and they come before Pharaoh again. Brother Eskel, the Bible said, Pharaoh said unto them, said, all right, you can go. You can go, but this time I want you to leave your children behind. That's what he said. You can go, but don't bring your children. Hey, man, look around today. I thank God for these little ones in the house of God this morning. Hey, man, but we're living in a day to where children aren't brought up and trained in the fear and the admiration of God. And our parents have left their children behind. Amen. Children telling parents, I don't need to go to church. I'm going to do what I want to do. I'm going to live the way I want to live.
Amen.
The world, amen, does that which makes them feel good. But the fact of the matter is, amen, God instructed us as godly parents to bring our children up in the house of God.
Amen.
And yet today, our churches are empty. with the young folks across the land. Amen. The world has got a grip on them. Amen. But Moses goes to Pharaoh and says to Pharaoh, said, no, our children are precious. They're precious in the sight of God. Amen. And God instructed us to take all that we have and go 3 days journey into the wilderness. And there were to sacrifice.
Yes.
Our daughter, Brother Jeff, needs the Lord. My wife, and I'll tell you, she's lost. And she needs the Lord.
Amen.
She needs to be saved. And I thought about that. Amen. But I trust the Word of God.
Amen.
I believe the Word of God.
Amen.
And the Bible teaches me. Amen. If I bring her up the way God wanted her brought up.
Amen.
And I rear her in the fear and the admiration of God.
Amen.
And when she's old, amen, she'll come back.
Amen.
Then we're going to take our children with us and go to the house of God. I used to tell them, see us, my little brother said it like this one time. My youngest brother said one time, he said, all four of us boys, amen, all three of my brothers, including myself, had a drug problem when we were little kids. Amen, because Mom drugged us to church every Sunday. Amen. We were at the house of God. Amen. I thank God for the drug problem and a mama that raised me in the house of God.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
I had them say to me, and I told you I'm preaching a pastoral message.
Good.
I've had them say, brother, I've had them say, well, it's revival, preacher, I know. We've got revival this week. I said, but my kids, I've got to get up and go to school.
Right.
Amen. You know what I told them? I said, that may be true. I said, but when I was a boy and revival happened, Mom would dress us in our pajamas and take us to church, and we might fall asleep. Amen. But we were in the house of God.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen. I played all kinds of sports. And revival would come, or Sunday would come around. And we'd have a ball game, Brother Jeff. Amen. But the coach already knew. Amen. That this boy was going to be late. The mom would say, get your uniform on. Get dressed for the game. And after church, I'll take you to the game.
Amen.
Moses said, we're not going to leave our kids behind. Can I encourage you, church? Don't leave your kids behind. Amen. And they might be growing. And they might be adults now. But it ain't no reason to leave them behind. Call them up and say, do you want to go to church with Mom and Dad today? Hey, we're going to church, son. Why don't you come? Amen. And Mom would say, go to church with us?
That's right.
Because we'll go to church.
We'll go to church.
You want to stay at home, stay here. But I'm going to church. Today they'll say, I've got company, I can't come to church.
You're right.
I'm glad we've got parents that still bring their children to church.
Amen.
Moses said to Pharaoh, no, we're going to go 3 days. I'm determined to go all the way, aren't you?
Amen.
Amen. I want to go all the way with the Lord. Later on in the scripture, amen, I see where Moses and Aaron come back to Pharaoh and say, let God sit, let my people go. Let us go 3 days into the wilderness, 3 days journey, and there we're going to worship the Lord. Amen. And Pharaoh, I struggled with some more things. Amen. One time he even said, leave your animals. Amen. But another time he said unto them, I said, all right, you can go. But leave your elders behind. Amen. Amen. But I'm glad Moses said no. I'm going to take mom and dad to church. Amen.
Amen.
I thank God. I see a woman in the scripture. And the Bible said she was the daughter of Abraham. Amen. And I see where the Bible said she was all bowed over. Amen. And for 18 years, she was like that. And now the Bible doesn't say. Amen. But I imagined in my mind maybe a brother or sister or family that began to talk. Amen. Maybe they said, you know, a sis has been going out of that church for 18 years. Amen. And said she's all bowed over. I said, when she sits down, it looks like she's tying her shoe. And when she sings, you can't hear her because her head is facing down. Maybe we ought to just let her stay at home. But thank God someone had enough sense to say, no, I'm going to take mama. I'm going to take daddy. I'm going down to the nursing home. I'm going to my neighbor. And I'm going to offer them a ride. And I'm going to take them a 3-day journey. And we're going to worship the Lord. We've got to go 3 days with God. We've got to go all the way with us 3 days. And today, so many have given up. They've given up. They quit fighting the fight. They're not running the course. And they're not going to finish a good race. Many are called, but few are chosen. Not everyone that cries, Lord, Lord, shall be redeemed. What I'm telling you this morning, church, is that Moses made it very clear to the world, or to Pharaoh, which is symbolic to the world, I'm going to go all the way. Hey, I'm not going to stop praying. No. Hey, man, you might remove the altar from the house of God. They might tell us in a restaurant, you can't bow your head. They might say in the school, you can't pray. may say you don't sound very good, but that's all right. I've got a song, and I'm going to sing unto the Lord. I'm going to sing praises. I'm going to let God know that I love Him. I'm going to let the world know that I'm happy. Amen. I'm going to let the world know that I've got joy down in my soul. Hey, preacher, don't you get weary. I sure do. And weeping may endure for the night, but joy comes in the morning. I was talking to an Amish guy just the other day. And he and I got talking about the Lord. And he was talking about the oppression that the government has put upon the Amish about gathering in houses and having church. Amen. The same thing's happening to us today. Amen. It sure is. Pastors are being jailed today in the United States for disobeying COVID rules. Amen. They sure are now. They are. Amen. We're living in a time. Amen. Where they said you can have church, but we only want 10 people there. Amen. That's what they're telling us in Michigan. Amen. You can have church. Amen. But you've got to have it this way and that way. Amen. But Moses said, hey, world, you can say what you want, but I'm determined to do what God says. Amen. Someone said, preacher, you've got to abide by the laws of the land. I said, if the laws of the land are contrary with the laws of God, I ain't got to listen to them. Amen. I'm determined to go all the way with God. I told the church, I said, I hope you got enough money to bail me out, because I'm going all the way. Moses said, Pharaoh, we're going 3 days' journey into the wilderness, and we'll do no less. Barristan, I'm going to do all that God wants me to do.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
And hey, the mouthpiece of God, you and I, ought to be louder today than we ever have been in our lives. Our children are dying lost.
Amen.
Without God. Hell's real. Hell's real.
Right.
Hell's real. I preached a message just a couple weeks ago. Amen. She brought in her mouth every day.
Every day.
Amen. But this way that leadeth unto heaven is straight and narrow. Amen. Amen. And Isaiah said it's a holy highway, and there's very few that are found upon it. And he said there'll be no unclean thing. Amen. Found upon that highway. I'm glad that the blood of Jesus, the precious Lamb of God, the ultimate sacrifice, the supreme sacrifice, died and shed his blood, that I could have life and have it more abundantly.
Amen.
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 Because of that, I'm determined to go a 3 day journey all the way with the Lord. But the Hebrews, I believe it's the 12th chapter, the Bible said, let us run with patience this race that is set before us. Amen. Let us lay aside every weight and sin that so easily beset us. Let us run with patience the race that is set before us.
Amen.
Amen. I want to keep running. saw on Facebook to where this church was having a grand reopening. And I thought to myself, a grand reopening. I said, my church has never closed down. It ain't never closed down. COVID might be happening. They may have shut us up in our homes, but I still serve a God that sits on the throne.
Amen.
I still serve a God that has all power in heaven and on earth. And I go to church every day. Every day I go to church. I'm going to go 3 days journey. Moses said, we're going 3 days, Pharaoh. Like it or not, we're going to go all the way. Did he face some opposition? He sure did. He sure did. Amen. But he was determined to get to a land that flowed. You know what heaven's going to be like? Boy, I can't wait. I can't wait. I know a fella, brother, that came down with cancer. Came down with cancer. A healthy man. His whole life came down with cancer. Came into the church, and he didn't say, oh, I've got cancer. Poor me, poor me. You know what he did, Brother Jim? He come in, and he said, ha, ha, ha. He said, I'm going to beat you. I'm going to beat you. I'm going to get down before you do. I'm going to